Today we will start the lecture on construction management and law. Already we have discussed various concepts related with the cost escalations. We have seen factors affecting cost escalations. We have seen the various requirements in order to reduce the cost escalations. There were many factors related with the labors or related with the equipments or materials required. Again, depending upon this, again the important topic related with the unit number one is types of cost. So very important is nothing but the various types of cost are there. The number one is the fixed cost. Okay, so number one is nothing but the fixed cost. What is fixed cost? Fixed cost is nothing but a cost of a commodity or a service or a product for a considerable period of time. It will not be changed. Okay, for a considerable period of time the cost will not be changed. Okay, such cost is nothing but the fixed cost. Okay, by considering the factors, when the factors will be same, that means the cost for a considerable period of time will be same. When the factors will be changed and the time will also be changed, then the cost will be changed. Okay, what is fixed cost? For a considerable amount of time and for the factors remain same. Okay, most important is the factors remain same. Okay, when the factors are same and the for a considerable amount of time, then it will then we will represent this cost as the fixed cost. Okay, so already this I have written here. It is the cost or a price of a commodity of an or an item which do not vary for a considerable amount of time. Also, second point is nothing but there could be several factors which results in the variation of cost or price. If all these factors remain same, okay, as I have already said, if the factors are same, that means the cost will be same. Such cost is nothing but the fixed cost. Two things to be taken concerned related with the fixed cost. Two things are very important. That for a considerable amount, for a considerable period of time, the time is also important, and the factors affecting factors should also be same. When the factors are same and for the time period. There is time bound is there, at that time there will be the cost related part will be the fixed cost. Okay, the factors remain same for a definite period, then the cost of that item is called as the fixed cost. Okay, same way opposite of that is nothing but the variable cost. If the cost of a material varies often with respect to time or change in factors, then it is known as the variable cost. Then it, if it is changes with the time, there is change in time, or if there is change in factors, okay, there is change in factors and the time also varies, the time period also varies and factors also varies, then such cost is nothing but the variable cost. It is just the opposite of the fixed cost. Okay, so fixed cost, time is same, time is considerable and the factors are also same, but in variable cost time also changes and factors also changes. So variable cost. So if the cost of the material varies often with respect to time or change in factors, then it is known as the variable cost. In practice, as the production increases due to increased demand in the market, it results in the large supply. Due to this, cost reduces because of competitions. When the productions are more and the requirement is less, okay, there are two parameters. When the production in the market, when the availability of the particular product is more, when the production is more and the demand in the market is less, demand is less and production is more, then that means the cost of that particular commodity is less. Okay, the cost of that particular product is less when the production is more. When the quantity of production is more and the requirement in the market is less, that means the cost will be less. Okay, and against this, what is the other thing related with this? When the production is less, when the production of a particular commodity of or a product is less and its requirement in the market is more, when the production of the particular product or when the availability of the particular material is less and the demand is more, that means the cost will be increased. That means the cost of that product will be increased. When there is no supply in the market, third point is nothing but when there is no supply in the market, heavy demand is created. Hence cost shoots up. Hence there is increase in the cost. What shoots up is nothing but the increase in the cost. When the demand is more and availability is less, when the demand is more or production is less, when the demand is more or there is scarcity of the material, availability of the material is less due to any circumstances. Okay? तो अगेन फोर्थ पॉइंट इज अगेन इंपॉर्टेंट इज नथिंग बट द टेंडेंसी ऑफ इंक्रीज एंड डिक्रीज इन द कॉस्ट ओवर अ शॉर्ट पीरियड इज कॉल्ड एज वेरिएबल. सच इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज इन द कॉस्ट, ठीक है, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द प्रोडक्शन, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द मार्केट सिनेरियो, देयर मे बी इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज इन द प्रोडक्ट कॉस्ट, ठीक है. सच इंक्रीज एंड डिक्रीज इज नथिंग बट द वेरिएबल कॉस्ट. सच इंक्रीज एंड डिक्रीज इन द प्रोडक्ट इज नथिंग बट द वेरिएबल कॉस्ट, ठीक है. नंबर थ्री इज नथिंग बट द प्राइम कॉस्ट. व्हाट इज द प्राइम कॉस्ट? द कॉस्ट विच हैज बीन रिक्वायर्ड फॉर प्रोड्यूसिंग अ पर्टिकुलर कमोडिटी, ठीक है. तो प्राइम कॉस्ट इज अ वे ऑफ मेजरिंग द टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन. द अमाउंट रिक्वायर्ड टू प्रोड्यूस अ कमोडिटी, द अमाउंट रिक्वायर्ड टू प्रोड्यूस और टू मैन्युफैक्चर अ पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ प्रोडक्ट, ठीक है. द प्राइम कॉस्ट इज अ वे ऑफ मेजरिंग द टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन नीडेड टू क्रिएट अ given output, ठीक है. We have to have a given output, we have to fulfill or we have to manufacture a given output. The total amount invested in order to produce a commodity, in order to produce a product, depending upon its specifications, depending upon the requirement, in order to produce a product, what are the total amount required? Such total amount is nothing but the prime cost, ठीक है. By analyzing its prime cost, a company can determine how much it must charge for its finished product in order to make a profit, ठीक है. तो the amount required for its production is different and the amount which has been fixed by a company for its selling price, for its selling is nothing but the different point, ठीक है. तो it will be fixed by the company how much margin of profit to be taken care, ठीक है. how much percentage of amount of profit to be maintained, ठीक है. तो depending upon prime cost it will be dependent, ठीक है. Depending upon the prime cost, it will be dependent. So what is prime cost? It is the total cost required for producing a commodity, for creating a commodity, for producing a commodity, for manufacturing a product, okay? The total production cost is nothing but the prime cost. By analyzing its prime cost, a company can determine how much charge for its finished product in order to make a profit, okay? So how much amount will be charged depending upon the production. If the production cost of the pen is nothing but 10 rupees, okay, or 8 rupees. So this is nothing but 8 rupees is nothing but the cost of a particular type of product. So after it is selling on the market, 2 extra rupees will be added as a profit by the manufacturers, okay. So that means the actual cost required for its production is 8 rupees. This 8 rupees is nothing but the prime cost, okay. Extra amount which has been added to this results in the profit related with the product, okay. What is the third point? Third point is nothing but by lowering its prime cost, a company can increase its profit margin or cut down its competitor's price, okay. By lowering the prime cost, a company can increase its profit. Okay, margin can be increased by decreasing in the prime cost. By lowering the prime cost, there may be increase in the profits. Okay, what is next? Next is nothing but fourth important type of cost is nothing but the supplementary cost. What is supplementary cost? The general cost of an undertaking as a whole, including administrations, interest, taxes, maintenance, depreciation, obsolescence, distinguished from the prime cost is called as supplementary cost. It is different than the prime cost, and in this supplementary cost, it is as a general cost. It has been in one line or one word, it has been described as a general cost. What is supplementary cost? The cost which has been required or which has been it has been kept aside for administrative works. Some documentary works will be required. It is not as such the production. There is only one thing to be taken care in the factories. Only production cost. No, the amount will be required for administrative work also. Okay, this administrative work will be taken care. Interest will be taken care. Taxes, various taxes to be paid. Maintenance work to be done. Depreciation is decrease in the production cost due to atmospheric action. What is depreciation? Depreciation is nothing but decrease in the product cost due to wear and tear. So in detail we will see the depreciation also, but here in short depreciation is nothing but the decay, decrease in the cost due to decay, decrease in the cost of a production, decrease in the cost of a commodity due to the decay, okay. What is obsolescence? Obsolescence is nothing but again the factor related with the present market. What is the market requirements? If the product is old, it is having a old pattern products or the manufacturing of old products are there, the its profit will be less. Okay, the obsolescence is outdated structures or outdated commodities or outdated products, manufacturing of outdated products which has been not required in the markets. So such products or such is nothing but the obsolescence. So depreciation, obsolescence and distinguished from the prime cost is nothing but the supplementary cost. It is very very different from the prime cost. Okay, so it is nothing but the supplementary cost. What is average cost? Average cost is nothing but the it is equal to the total cost divided by the number of goods produced. If suppose a company is producing a 1000 number of products, okay, so total amount required for producing a 1000 number of products divided by the 1000 numbers. Okay, if it is in lakhs, suppose 30 lakhs or 25 lakhs is the total cost of required for production of 1000 or 5000 products, then that total amount will be divided by the products, number of products which has been manufactured. Okay, so it is as simple as that. Average cost, average, as this word relates, we have to average the total production cost, total cost divided by the number of products which has been produced in the particular manufacturing company. So it is equal to the total cost divided by the number of goods produced. It is also equal to the sum of average variable cost plus average fixed cost. What is it is also the sum of, it is the addition of average variable cost plus average fixed cost. Number three is nothing but average cost may be dependent on time period considerations. It will be dependent on time. As the time changes, that means average cost will be changed. Okay, so it will be totally dependent on the time. Okay, as the time span will be increase or decrease, the production cost will be the average cost will be increase or decrease. Okay, so it will be totally dependent on time. So it is dependent on time period considerations. What is fourth point? Fourth point is nothing but average cost affects the supply curve and are a fundamental component of supply and demand. Okay, so depending upon supply and depending upon the demand, okay, how much amount of production it has been done in the market, in the factories, and how much amount of product it has been utilized in the market, okay, it has been sold in the market, or what is the requirement in the market. Okay, the supply and demand, so depending upon supply and demand, average cost will be fixed. How much production it has been done in the factory and how much is the requirement in the market. Okay, so supply and demand. Okay, marginal cost, again important type of cost is nothing but the marginal cost. So marginal cost is nothing but there is slight change in the product. If there is a fixed amount of production is there, suppose a particular type of vehicle it has been manufactured, suppose 100 quantity of a particular type of same type of vehicle it has been manufactured, and after 101 type of vehicle it has been manufactured with somewhat difference in the in its external features. So there may be change in its look, there may be change in its color, there may be change in its various aspects. That means the cost required for change in the previous product, the cost required, the in the change in the product is nothing but the marginal cost. Okay, if we are producing a commodity, that means if 100 products are same and 101 product, the next product it is different than the previous product, the different product, the product which has been different from the previous product, the amount required for its production, the amount required for its manufacturing is nothing but the marginal cost. Okay, in short, that is a change in the total cost that arises when the quantity produced changes by one unit, when there is change in the only one unit also. Okay, because there is change in the total its features, there is change in the in its particular type of product. That means whole arrangement will be done, whole manufacturing unit will be changed, whole its equipments required for its change in the particular type of product will be changed. So that means that cost, extra cost required, is nothing but the marginal cost. So it is the change in the total cost that arises when the quantity produced changes by one unit. It is the cost of producing one unit of a good. In general terms, marginal cost at each level of production includes any additional cost required to produce the next product. This next word is important. Okay, previous products were same, but next product it is somewhat different than the previous product. So what is that somewhat different? So somewhat different will require somewhat different equipments will be required, somewhat advanced equipments will be required, or some setup will be required, some extra equipments will be required to produce a next unit. Next unit, this next word is important. Okay, in second point this next word is important. So this next, in order to produce this, we have to have somewhat different things. Okay, so again there is an example for marginal cost. For example, if producing additional vehicles require building a new factories, the marginal cost of the extra vehicles includes the cost of the new factories. As I've already given the example of vehicle, the same example it has been repeated here. The same example of vehicle it has been there. If we are producing 100 vehicles of same model or features, but 101 model, the next model it has been changed. The amount required for its production will be changed. The equipments required, the various manufacturing units required will be changed. Such amount will be required. Such amount is considered in the marginal cost. Next is again important is what is meant by infrastructure project and what are the examples. Okay, so as I have already discussed, what is infrastructures? Infrastructures is nothing but a long term structural constructions. Okay, a long term it is whether it is a production industries or whether it is a manufacturing industry or whether it is a construction industries or construction. So long term construction is considered as an infrastructure project. Okay, what is meant by infrastructure project? A long term, there will be a long term construction work will be done, a long term production work will be done, a long term if it is a power plant is there, infrastructure project, there is a power station there, so there may be long term generation of power will be there. If there is extraction of coals from the various quarries, so there will be a long term extraction of coals. Okay, the long term work is considered in the infrastructure projects. Okay, so infrastructure is the basic physical system of a business or nation, like transportation, communication, sewage, water and electric system. Okay, so it is totally the nation depends upon this infrastructure project. The strong the infrastructure project will be there, the strong will be the nation. Okay, because nation will be distinguished with by the infrastructure projects. Okay, what are the different long term projects they are they are under construction in the nation. Okay, the first point is again important. The infrastructure is the basic physical system of a business or nation, like transportations. As I've already said, transportation is the infrastructure project. Construction of roads, construction of highways, construction of bridges, construction of various transportation through air also, transportation through water also, transportation through rails also, various metros also. So transportations, communications, okay? Sewage is also infrastructure projects. Water distribution, water purification of water, water distribution are also there. Dams are also comes under the infrastructure project. Electric systems, generation of power or distribution of power. So all this will be covered in the infrastructure projects. Okay, so communication, transportation, communication is the telephonic communications. Okay, communication word relates with the communications is this word is related with the communication of voice. Okay, so transportation, communication, sewage, water, electric systems, etc. What is second point? These systems are high cost investments and are vital for a country economic development and prosperity. In order to maintain the prosperity of a country, in order to maintain the economic development of country, economic in the countries, this projects plays an important role. These fields plays an important role. Whether the field there is a field of transportation, whether there is field of communications, sewage or water or electric systems, so these fields are very very important. This will represent the prosperity of the country. This will represent the economic state of the country. Whether this what is the economic status of the country, this will be represented by this infrastructure projects. Okay, so these systems may be funded publicly, privately or through PPP. Okay, so these projects, whether it is transportation projects, communication or sewage or water or electric system projects, so all these will be funded publicly or it will be funded privately or both. public private partnerships. Already we have discussed triple P. What is triple P? Public private partnership. There is partnership of public as well as private. Okay, construction work will be done by the private sectors, and the cost will be the amount will be recovered from the public. Okay, so public private partnerships, it will be taken care in this infrastructure projects. Okay. Again, fourth point in this infrastructure project is nothing but the construction sector is the second largest employer in India after agriculture. Okay, so the second largest that is the economical background things will be considered. Construction sector is the second largest employer in India after agriculture because large amount of labors will be required, a large amount of various manpowers will be, equipments will be required. So it is second largest employer in the construction sectors is nothing but the second largest employer in India after agriculture. What is next? Serial number 5 is nothing but 32 million workers. It employs 32 million workers and accounts about 5% of India's GDP. Okay. So GDP about 5% will be taken by the construction sectors, because 32 million workers, they are working in this construction sectors, whether they are laborers or whether they are engineers or various key post holders are there, stakeholders are there. So all this accounts to about 32 million workers are working in construction sectors, which will result in the 5% of the India's GDP. So total 5% will be bared by this construction sectors. Investment in construction sector includes infrastructures, that is roads, railways, airports, bridges, highways. As I've already said, infrastructure will include roads, railways, airports, bridges, highways. Again, industrial if it is infrastructures are related, then industrial steel plants, textile plants, oil pipelines, refrigerators, so all this will be included in the industrial sectors. Real estate, that is the residential and commercial buildings, will be considered under the real estate. These are the various investments in the construction sectors. Infrastructure is a various head. These are the three heads related with the investment in construction sectors. Next is nothing but the examples. Okay, examples of infrastructure projects in India. So these are the various examples related with the infrastructure projects in India. So highway, streets and roads, the construction of highway, streets and roads. Two things to be considered. If we are reconstructing or we are having resurfacing. Okay, highway, streets and roads, there may be maintenance works also, there may be reconstruction also. Okay, so there are two different heads in highway, streets and roads. Okay, so maintenance cost will be less, but actual construction cost will be more. Okay, in some situations, if the maintenance cost is more, then it is preferably be it will be preferred that there should be a reconstruction of roads. Okay, so reconstruction of roads can also be done. Okay, so highway, streets and roads. So highway, streets and roads are common types of infrastructure construction projects. While more often than streets and roads are repairs projects, they are no less complex logistically than other infrastructure projects. There may be repair of roads may be there may be a repair of highway, streets, but it is the amount required is less as compared to the constructions. Okay, the reconstructions. Okay, it's less expensive than what is fourth point. It is less expensive than street reconstruction. However, it is a temporary fix. But street reconstruction is an infrastructure construction project that provides long-term fixes to an already existing road, and sometimes it is only way to repair it. Okay, so if it is more amount is required for resurfacing or for maintenance work, then it is preferably there should be a reconstruction. Okay, reconstruction of highways or reconstruction of streets or roads. The highway construction can be resurfacing or reconstruction. However, expansion projects are also very common in the congested areas. Okay, expansion projects are also there, expansion of roads also there, expansion of bridges also there, expansion of various streets are also there. The expansion projects are also there, resurfacing projects are also there, and reconstruction projects are also there. Okay, so these all will be covered in highway, streets and roads. Next is bridges. Again, example of infrastructure projects in India are bridges. So bridges is again very, very important. bridges are important part of infrastructure construction projects. 4% of highway bridges considered to carry significant traffic as considered structurally deficient. Because we are having only 4%, okay? So 4% bridges are they are very limited amount of bridges are there. So there are mass transportation. So these 4% bridges are very much deficient in having in order to control the traffic. So therefore we require more construction of bridges. Okay? However, structurally deficient doesn't mean unsafe. Okay? Most of these bridges just need repairs, but bridges repairs can be large undertakings. Okay? Project managers might find the logistics and expenses more complicated with heavily trafficked bridges infrastructure maintenance and repair works. When there are heavy traffics are there, at that time the maintenance work cannot be done. There is a big challenge regarding maintenance work. When maintenance work is to be done for bridges, so when there is a heavy traffic bridges are there, so there is a challenge for project managers or engineers to have maintenance work to be done along this heavy traffic bridges. Okay, with the increase in infrastructure spending, many of these bridges might receive repairs. Okay, many of the bridges requires repairs works. Little bridges they are reconstructed, but many of the bridges they require the repair works. Okay. What is the third important example of infrastructure projects? Third example is nothing but the mass transit, that is mass scale transportation system, or airports and airways. One area of infrastructure construction projects that is growing is airport retrofitting. Okay, what is retrofitting? If there is repair work of runways, maybe there repair works of various structures in the airports may be there. So retrofitting work it has been done. Okay, retrofitting is the nowadays it has been most commonly used. This is advanced repairing techniques, maintenance technique in which retrofitting work it has been done in order to increase the strength of a particular type of structure, in order to maintain the strength of the particular type of road or air or runway or any type of structures. Retrofitting technique is nowadays most commonly used. Okay, so airport retrofitting. Many of the nation's largest infrastructure construction projects are airport reconstruction and retrofitting. Reconstruction and retrofitting are the nowadays construction of new airports are there, reconstruction of airports are there, and retrofitting work is also taking care. Many airports haven't been updated in many years and are in need of retrofitting. So retrofitting is to be done for the structures which has been old. The old type of structures, old types of airport, the retrofitting work is nowadays it has been taken into considerations. What is fourth point? The overhauling of our nation's air travels and mass transit systems are the most needed infrastructure construction projects. Mass transit, that is nothing but nation's air travels and mass transit system, that is airports, airways, as nowadays it is a growing field in infrastructure construction projects. These projects often require not only the laying or relaying of utilities and services, but also of runways. Okay, so runways to be reconstructed, runways to be repaired, or retrofitting will be done. So various concerns will be taken care regarding with the airports. So again, this airport or mass transit or airways, it has been considered under the example of the infrastructure projects. Okay, so water supply and resources are incredibly crucial to life, because water plays an important role. Without water, we cannot have the life on earth totally depends upon water. The water related part is very, very again important. Construction of dams is also important. Construction of various pipelines or flow of water from upstream to downstream, or various flow of water it requires various pipelines are required. So therefore this water supply and resources are very, very important field related with the infrastructure projects. Okay, so depending upon states you live in and what the local laws are there, many of the water infrastructure projects are on अपडेटिंग वाटर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सर्विसेज एंड इम्प्रूविंग ड्रफ्ट रेजिस्टेंस. ठीक है, देयर मे बी ड्रफ्ट इन रीजन्स. तो डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द लॉज, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द नॉर्म्स, द गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग एक्शन रिगार्डिंग द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ वाटर. ठीक है, द वाटर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सेक्टर्स इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. हाउ टू वी हैव टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द वाटर थ्रू पाइपलाइंस. तो वाटर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सर्विसेज आर अगेन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट्स इन ऑर्डर टू अवॉइड द ड्रफ्ट. वाटर सप्लाई एंड रिसोर्स इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कंस्ट्रक्शन प्रोजेक्ट्स आर क्रूशियल टू इंश्योर प्रॉपर वाटर मैनेजमेंट. द रेट्रोफिटिंग ऑफ दिस फैसिलिटीज इंश्योर्स एक्यूरेट एंड इफेक्टिव वाटर ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड रिड्यूसेज द नंबर ऑफ लीक्स. ठीक है, तो इफेक्टिव वाटर ट्रांसपोर्ट टू बी डन, देर शुड बी मिनिमम लीकेज, मिनिमम वेस्टेज ऑफ द वाटर फ्रॉम व्हेन इट हैज बीन ट्रांसपोर्टेड फ्रॉम अपस्ट्रीम टू डाउनस्ट्रीम, from where it has been stored and from where it has been used. So there should be a minimum leakage, okay, wastage. So serial number 5 is again important, waste management and waste water management. Again, the waste which has been water waste management and waste water management is one of the most important type of infrastructure construction projects. It is what keeps citizens safe. In order to avoid the safe environment, again waste management and waste water management is very very important. ठीक है, the safe transportation of waste from residential and commercial areas keep our cities clean. We have to transport the waste water from our household from where we have to dump. ठीक है, तो the transportation safe transportation should be there. ठीक है, it is again an infrastructure projects. तो waste products can include trash, recyclings and the waste water. ठीक है, रिसाइकलिंग और ट्रैश और वेस्ट वाटर रिसाइकलिंग विल बी देयर. इन ऑर्डर टू रिड्यूस द डिजीजेस, इन ऑर्डर टू रिड्यूस द स्प्रेड ऑफ पेस्ट और इन ऑर्डर टू रिड्यूस द डिजीजेस, दिस प्लेज एन इंपॉर्टेंट रोल. टू कीप सिटीजन सेफ, वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कंस्ट्रक्शन प्रोजेक्ट्स इंश्योर्स दैट द फैसिलिटीज वेयर दिस प्रोडक्ट्स आर स्टोर्ड are properly built and maintained. ठीक है,
अमीन सर का फोन आ रहा है, क्या बोल अमीन
पास. नंबर 6 इज नथिंग बट द पावर जनरेशन एंड ट्रांसमिशन. अगेन इट इज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट्स विल बी देयर. पावर जनरेशन एंड ट्रांसमिशन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कंस्ट्रक्शन प्रोजेक्ट्स इंक्लूड्स पावर जनरेशन एंड ट्रांसमिशन. दिस प्रोजेक्ट्स कैन इंक्लूड कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द पावर जनरेशन प्लांट. It also will include the facilities and structures necessary to store the power and transmit power. We have to first to generate the power and transmit the power. Generation is a different process is there, and transmission distribution is again the process, different process. So in electrification there are two different things to be considered. First we have to produce the electricity and then we have to transmit the electricity. Okay, then we have to transfer the electricity. Okay, so it is also will include the facilities and structures necessary to store the power and transmit power. Since these facilities are incredibly important to the infrastructure of the country, the construction is important. Depending upon the region and laws, some states have moved to underground utilities like power. Okay, so there is underground power stations also, underground transmission of power lines also. So depending upon the whether metro cities are there, different cities are there, so power there is transmission of power through underlying pipelines. Okay, again telecommunication is again an important field. Telecommunication is nothing but interconnected with each other. The worlds are interconnected with telecommunications. Again, this telecommunications plays an important role. Telecommunication is what allows the world to be an interconnected as it is. As a result, the infrastructure construction projects surrounding telecommunications are essentials. There are two things to be considered. In some regions, there may be limited access, or in metropolitan cities, there may be a congested telecommunication service. Okay. In some villages, there may be limited access of the telecommunications, or in metropolitan cities, there may be congested in telecommunications. So, these two things too, it is also to be considered. There should not be a limited access in the villages, and there should be a proper telecommunication service in the metropolitan cities also. Okay? So, again, this telecommunication plays an important role. And last is nothing but the hazardous waste removal and storage. Okay? तो रिमूवल इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड इट्स स्टोरेज. वी कैन नॉट डंप द हैजर्डस वेस्ट डायरेक्टली इन टू द रिवर, इन टू द पाउंड, इन टू द वाटर, बट देर आर सर्टन नॉर्म्स आर टू बी टेकन केयर, सम क्लॉजेज टू बी टेकन केयर, बिकॉज दिस हैजर्डस वेस्ट विल रिजल्ट इन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ, इट विल पल्यूट द हेल्थ, इट विल पल्यूट द इन्वायरमेंट. ठीक है, तो वेरियस मेजर्स टू बी टेकन केयर. ठीक है, अगेन देर शुड बी वेरियस कंस्ट्रक्शन, वेरियस कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्क टू बी डन इन ऑर्डर टू हैव, इन ऑर्डर टू स्टोर दिस हैजार्डस वेस्ट. तो हैजार्डस वेस्ट रिमूवल इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट टाइप ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कंस्ट्रक्शन प्रोजेक्ट्स. दिस इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर कंस्ट्रक्शन प्रोजेक्ट्स आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर इंश्योरिंग दैट हार्मफुल मटेरियल्स लाइक न्यूक्लियर मटेरियल्स आर सेफली स्टोर्ड. फर्स्ट इट इज टू बी स्टोर्ड, इट शुड बी स्टोर्ड सेफली स्टोर्ड. And the safe construction of these sites is crucial to maintain a healthy populations. Okay, infrastructure contractors that specialize in the hazardous construction understand the gravity of their projects. Okay, those contractors they are having a strong knowledge related with the construction of this hazardous storage. So they are given an opportunity for construction of this because it is very very important. Because depending upon the pollutions or depending upon the health environment, so we have to construct such construction of such storage of the hazardous waste properly with the proper norms to be maintained, with proper laws to be maintained regarding the construction of this hazardous storage. Okay, so these are the 8 important examples of the infrastructure projects. Okay. So in this way we have seen various concepts related with the unit number 1. So in next lecture we will see some more concept, but in next lecture we will see unit number 2. Here we will end the unit number 1. So we have depending upon the syllabus of unit number 1, we have covered almost all the things related with the unit number 1. In next lectures we will start the unit number 2. So thank you. Thank you.